All righty, time for another edition of Science Sunday. Of course, joined by Aoife Ryle of the Connecticut Science Center.
Good morning.
Good morning, good morning. So, happy 4th to everyone.
Yeah, happy 4th.
And, you know, summer is here. We've had many 90-degree days already. Mm-hmm. And it's always a good reminder and a good topic, especially for those who have pets, about dogs and cars.
Yes, yeah, this time of year can be really dangerous for dogs left in hot cars, and it really doesn't take that long. And so I wanted to show you all today why. We have a heat lamp here that's going to represent the sun.
Okay.
Underneath it, I have a jar that's going to represent our sealed car.
Okay.
So it's made of glass, as our light can get in.
Makes sense.
In order to kind of see what happens in the sealed container versus outside, we have some thermometers.
Okay.
Right, so we can see what the temperature looks like. These are kind of cool. They show us the temperature based on their color.
All
right. So wherever it's kind of greeny blue, that's the temperature.
All right, so we're going to watch it go up because like it's 72.
Right now, yeah, they're both at 70. About 72. So we're going to stick one inside the jar, one next to it, and see how the temperature might vary and change.
All right.
So we're going to put one in.
Let's do that one. And then this will be right next to it, but outside, clearly, of glass. All right.
Yeah, so we're going to leave it there for a while. Here's our poor dog inside the car and our dog who's happy outside of the car.
All right, so while that is happening.
While that's sitting there, we're going to talk a little bit about how we cool ourselves in the summer versus how our dogs cool themselves.
All right.
So we can do this great thing. We sweat.
Yeah.
You know, it doesn't feel that great sometimes, but it is.
Because that's our body's way of naturally cooling itself, is we sweat, and then that sweat evaporates.
Exactly, yeah. So when that evaporates off our skin, it takes heat with it. That cools the blood close to the surface of our skin, and that circulates back, keeping us cool.
All right.
But our dogs, they can't sweat. They can't do that.
So how do they cool themselves?
They pant. And so that's something we see our dogs doing. And that's also evaporative cooling. Their saliva is evaporating, taking the heat with it. But they can't sweat all over their whole body like we can.
Okay.
So we're going to look at how that works. I'm going to have you hold your hands out like this.
Okay.
I'm going to put a drop of rubbing alcohol in one hand. I'm not going to tell you which one.
I'm closing my eyes.
And water on the other one. So close your eyes. And you're going to tell me which one feels cooler.
All right.
So there's one.
Okay, that's kind of refreshing.
Right.
Oh, it's noticeably cooler on the left hand.
On the left hand?
Yeah.
Yeah. So that was the rubbing alcohol.
Ah.
Rubbing alcohol evaporates from your skin about 4 times as fast as water does. So it's evaporating quickly, taking the heat off your skin with it. So that's how we cool ourselves. We can sweat up to 14 liters a day, which is insane.
I believe it. I sweat a lot. Yeah. And also kind of a cool little weather, you know, element too is like the dew point. We talk about that a lot because that's, you know, measures the moisture content of the air. So whenever we have dew point values in the 70s, it's more difficult for our bodies to cool themselves through sweating.
That's cool. Yeah. I didn't even think of that. So we can go back to this real quick. I'm going to talk about it a little bit. So the light from the sun travels through the glass of our car inside, that visible light. It gets absorbed by our seats, our consoles, the dashboard, and it gets readmitted as heat. That heat can escape through the windows the same way that the visible light can come in, so it gets trapped inside that air. And since that air is trapped and it can't circulate, it can't rise and circulate with cooler air, it just keeps getting hotter and hotter. So let's take a look.
I think we're off the charts on that one, aren't we?
Yeah, this one is actually above 93. That's all the way off. This one's at 80.
Wow. So is only, what, 2 minutes?
About 2 minutes.
Yeah.
And that's, what, a 13 or so degree difference? Just in about two and a half minutes. So that can give you an idea of, even if you're running into the store for 15 minutes, your car can really start heating up quickly because that air's trapped.
Don't bring your pets, your dogs. Do not leave them in the car.
We love them. We want to keep them happy.
All right. And I know like Teslas, they actually have a dog mode. So if you see a dog in a Tesla, think twice before you call the police or maybe break open the window.
That's cool.
Yeah, all right. So we should let everyone know about something happening at the Science Center that's actually happening for quite some time, this whole summer.
Yeah, so speaking of dogs, we love dogs at the Science Center. Our dog days of summer are coming up. All through July, we'll have specific dog-themed programming. Our Paw Patrol friends are coming in on Fridays and Saturdays. And we have this great new movie called Superpower Dogs. It's adorable and amazing, and it's in our theater throughout the whole summer, so come check it out.
So the Dog Days of Summer events, we should say, are included with general admission.
Yes.
However, if you do want to come see the movie, it is an additional charge.
Yes, it is.
All right.
But super worth it.
Oh, yeah, definitely. All right, Aoife, thank you so much, and we'll, of course, see you for another edition of Science Sunday next weekend.